All right, what's up, everybody? It is time for some more Legend of Zelda. This is part two of my playthrough of the original Legend of Zelda. I'm playing the Switch version using my cool retro fighters controller. You can see it's like a, you know, see-through kind of greenish color, N64 style buttons and all that good stuff. So that's the controller I'm using. It's a Bluetooth controller for my Switch, and I'm playing the Switch version of the game because I like to cheat, and I'm using all of the cool rewind features and whatnot. So that's what I'm doing, and I just finished the fifth dungeon whenever I signed off last night. That was two nights ago. Two nights ago. And I have all of the hearts that I can get that are optional. So I've only got three hearts remaining from the three final dungeons. I've got the best sword. I've got the blue ring, which halves the damage you take from enemies and damage. I've got the power bracelet. So I wasn't even really intending on doing like 100% playthrough, but that's kind of what I ended up doing by sort of by accident. Because I'm using a guide. Whoops. Hang on. There we go. I'm using a guide for this playthrough, so yeah, that's where we're at. We're sitting pretty nice right now. We've got all of our optional stuff taken care of. We're ready to take on the sixth dungeon, and yeah, according to the map that I'm referencing here, it looks like this dungeon is kind of close to where I'm at right now. Really? There we go. I'm playing on a second monitor this time, so it might look like I'm kind of looking off to the side now because I'm looking at a second screen. But the reason I'm doing that is because I really wanted to get rid of the lag that I was having last time. If you watched last time, you might have heard me complaining about a slight delay issue. And that was because I was watching the output screen of my capture card. And there is just a very, very minor delay when you do that. So that's gone now. So my movement is much more precise this time around, thankfully. Let's see. Let me just go ahead and I think I'm going to head back to the start because there's a shortcut that I can access from there. Wait, this is at the start. Oh, I see where I need to go. Using a map makes this game so much more playable. Like, you know, all the respect in the world to the kids of the 80s that happily played this game without a map, but it's much more fun if I can use a map. Because if you think about it, nowadays, games like this would have maps built in, right? They were definitely better than us, I agree. Where is this at? So I need to go over one more. And then down. And this is the start, I think, right? Right over here? Yeah, there we go. So I have the power bracelet, which means I can move boulders that were previously too heavy to move. So like this one here. Look at that. And this is a shortcut. There we go. Now we're right over here next to where the sixth dungeon is. I think this is it right here. Man, those guys said tons of fairies. What the heck's going on? So I have half of a potion. I think I can buy a potion and back over where I started at just a second ago. Oh, is the game screen frozen? Sorry, Resonator, thank you. Hang on. I didn't even realize. There we go. Man, thank you for pointing that out. Oh my god. How embarrassing. You thought I wasn't playing? Whoops. Oh my god. I appreciate you. Thank you very much. I think there's a shop here. Yeah, there we go. Man, I don't have enough money. Ah, dang it. Okay. Do these guys drop money? Or no? I don't know if they drop money. It's definitely seeming like they don't drop money. Yeah. I don't think they drop money. Man. I hate taking damage unnecessarily, but whatever. Okay. Our save point has been created right outside of dungeon number 6. So, I've got everything pulled up for this. What I like to do whenever I go into a dungeon is, even though I'm using a guide, I like to just attempt the dungeon blind and see how it goes. And if I get stuck, then I'll check the guide. So, we'll see how that goes. That's going to be my strategy. Have you played Daggerfall, Parrots? I've never, like, done a full playthrough of that game. I've played it a little bit. Okay, so my shield blocks those. Okay, gotcha. I see what you mean. It's a cool game. It's really ambitious. It's crazy that that game even got made back when it did. But I'm crazy excited for Starfield. I'm excited for the next Elder Scrolls when it eventually comes out. Aim at the eyes of Goma. Oh, Goma's the boss. That's cool. Goma's the boss in the original Deku Tree of Ocarina of Time. Let's see. Is it going to recommend... You know what? I don't have any arrows. I'm looking at the little guide here, and it says all you have to do is shoot Goma in the eye with an arrow, and she dies instantly. That's the entire boss fight. But I don't have any arrows. So I might have to go buy some arrows before I can fight her. Okay. These wizrobes are pretty simple. I remember fighting the wizrobes in Majora's Mask, and those things were annoying. Hey, what's up, Hunter? Sorry, Hyrule Savior, my bad. Do you remember whenever we had planned to play every Zelda game before Skyward Sword came out? And then, I don't know how far you got in that process. If I remember correctly, we kind of played this one together a little bit, taking turns, and then we played, like, most of Link to the Past. I don't remember what happened with the rest. Okay, so you did get through Link to the Past that time? Oh my god. Yeah, for people in the chat, Hyrule Savior here was one of my college roommates, sophomore and junior year. And former debate partner. No! No! What do I need to do here? There we go. I don't like this. I don't like this. Nope. This is where you rewind it. Nope. We're gonna do a full reset here. I feel like I'm playing Bomberman. Man, this is so dumb. I hate whenever games do this. When they just give you former bosses as enemies. Let's go ahead and heal up. That is so unnecessary that it takes so long. I don't really want to use my bombs. I feel like they're going to be useful. Let's go. Just spam it. I'm doing damage, aren't I? Am I not even doing damage this whole time? I don't think I was. Nope, I wasn't even doing damage that whole time. I forgot I have projectiles. Okay, let's just use that for now. Okay, we're down to just one head. No! There we go. That wasn't so bad. I'll go ahead and bank that one. That turned out okay. Oh, I wasted a bomb. Let's rewind. There we go. I can't even imagine trying to play through this dungeon without the magic sword or the blue ring for the tunic. That'd be such a pain. Just so unnecessarily difficult, you know? Like especially these guys. This sword that I have does 4 times the damage of the starting sword. How long would it have taken me to kill all these if I just had the starting sword? That would have been completely ridiculous. Just the magic wand or whatever. What does this even do? In this game, what does the magic wand do? Okay, so it's kind of like shooting an arrow, basically. But Goma, I think I need an arrow in the eye to win. Which means I'll probably end up having to go buy some arrows. Right? Because I haven't found a single arrow. I don't know, maybe is that just because I haven't bought any yet, so the game, like, I don't have a quiver, technically. Are they, like, immune or something? This is stupid. Oh, arrows just cost rupees? No, see, I can't even equip it. I'm gonna have to go heal up probably anyway. Maybe I just have to equip it once, or like, buy arrows once as like a quiver type of situation or something. Oh, so I have to just buy the arrow first, okay. Well, I'm stupid. I figured once I found the bow, they would start dropping, but they never did. Man, what's going on in this room? I'm gonna look up a guide. I don't want to waste my time and energy here. What's going on in this room? I pushed. Neither of those blocks will move. There's no door. I'm very confused. Which room is this? The top right one? I don't think there's anything else in this room. Let's try bombing with some walls. Aha, there we go. There are secrets where fairies don't live. Okay. So, what even is... Is there a way to tell which rooms you have or have not been to yet? I don't think the map shows that, does it? I must be able to go to the right from here. Is what I'm guessing. Because I can see where the boss is. That's the blinking... Dang it, dang it. No! Oh, God. I got completely destroyed in this room. Can we roll this one back? Ah, dang it. Those stupid guys stunned me or whatever. Hum the song of time every time I do a rewind. That's not a bad idea. Thank you. Oh, that's a good idea. That would be a good Stream Deck button. I need to get my audio alerts set back up again, the sound alerts and stuff that I had tied to channel points. Because none of those work right now. Does this room connect? How am I supposed to get there? I don't know how to get to the boss. Oh, hey, look! We've got ourselves a nice little spam account going on here. Is there a way that I can... Yeah, there we go. Banned. Thank you. I don't think any of my moderators are watching right now. There must be another staircase. You want to be a moderator? Sure, why not? How do I do that? I'm trying to remember. Is it just slash mod? Is that a command that I can do? Did that work? Is that a thing? I did! It did work! Look at that, he's a mod now. Look, everybody. Unlimited power! I genuinely am confused about where I'm supposed to go. Like... I'm pretty sure... Aw, crap. Let's rewind that. I don't want to walk into my own fire. There must be a hidden staircase, right? Like, that's the only logical... explanation. There's gotta be a hidden staircase. Tripe's pushing the block. Oh no. Oh god. Oh god. I think what I might end up doing is I should probably back out. Oh yeah, I have an affiliate code for Dubby if you want some delicious energy drinks. There you go, parrots. I need to go buy arrows anyway, so I might as well leave. Let's see. The whistle doesn't seem super useful. Like, it just teleports you around to the different dungeons, doesn't it? Like, where I'm at now, where's the best place to buy some arrows? So, I can get to some arrow, I can get to a fairy fountain pretty easily from here. Let's go this way. And just keep on going across a little bit here. Then right up here is the fairy fountain. So I can at least heal real quick. I gotta figure out where's the easiest place for me to buy arrows. Is it over here? I know isn't there a shop right over here? Is this the arrow shop? Yes! Dang it! I need 80. Okay. Let's see. Where I'm at here, I can get to that rupee game where I can cheat and get some easy money. So the easiest way to get there is just to hug all the way around this way. You know, if I'm being perfectly honest, I don't know if I've ever actually completed this game. I might have just watched friends play it. And like my brothers and stuff. I know I remember watching them beat it. But I don't know if I ever did myself. Hell yeah. Let's do this a couple more times. I know I've never beaten Zelda 2, that's for sure. Whoops. There we go. Haha! We beat this game together, are you sure? I remember getting stuck in a room that had like 6 dark nuts in it and having to like maneuver around them carefully, and I remember we were stuck in that room forever, and I think we were using an emulator, so we had save states but we couldn't rewind like you can on Switch. We just had save states you had to trigger. Yeah, I don't think I personally beat this one with you. I may have watched you finish it. Yeah, we definitely did not finish two. I know that for sure. It'll be so much easier now with rewind, though. Whoops, wrong way. And I've beaten Link to the Past at least a couple times. It's been a long time since I played it, but I've definitely beat that game more than once. Link's Awakening, I think I only played the one time when I was younger. There we go. I finally have arrows, everybody. I wonder how this works now. Will it send me to number dungeon 6? Which one is this? Okay, this is dungeon 1. Link to the Past, I probably haven't actually finished Link to the Past in... It's got to be at least 15 years, maybe? 10, 15 years? How do I get to... Is there a way to choose which dungeon you teleport to? I feel like there must be some sort of method to the whistle. Can you, like... Do you get to pick at all where you go? Or does it just send you between 5 and 1 or something? Like, which one is this? Is this 6? This is 4. Wait, 4 is actually kind of close. Hang on. Okay. But I wish you could choose which one it takes you to. I'm just gonna do the shortcut again. I'm gonna go back to the start, and then I can shortcut over to number 6. That's a lot faster that way. Wait, wrong way. I was supposed to go down back here. There we go. Wonderful. I should go buy another potion. I've got arrows now. There we go. I'm getting like fully loaded up here, guys. I'm ready to take on the rest of this dungeon. I just gotta figure out how to actually get to Goma. Okay. Let me just go ahead and cheat real quick. I'm gonna look. Okay, then there's that. There's a staircase I missed. Yeah, there's a staircase. I found it. Okay. Oh my god. Where's he at? Alright. Okay. Might as well take these guys out, right? Get some rupees at least. I had the chance to upgrade my bombs in a previous dungeon, but... I did not do it. Because I didn't have the money. And I didn't feel like coming back. This must be a hidden path. This has to be. Really? Leave me alone. I don't like this. Oh my god. Oh yeah, there's still a lifelike. Duh. Oh my gosh, guys. Hang on. We're rewinding that. I lost two hearts instantly. When I walked in this room. No, there's a heart. There we go. Oh god. Please tell me. Okay. Yeah, I missed all these rooms last time. There we go. I'm getting real tired of these rooms. Which other Zelda games have you never played before, Hunter? Or Hyrule Savior? I don't know if you care about me using your real name or not. I've never played Minish Cap at all. I've heard it's really good. Oh my god, that I can't believe that boss is just one arrow. Arguably even easier than Goma from Ocarina of Time. Okay, including Death Mountain, I have three dungeons left. Yeah, I've never played the CDI ones either. I'm thinking about setting up like a, I don't know, a follower goal or like a bits goal or a channel points goal or something. Oh yeah, Triforce Heroes on 3DS. And so I've heard the Four Swords Adventure game, you can actually play that solo. So I'm gonna try to play those as part of the marathon type thing, but both of those are kind of near the end anyway. Yeah, Yeah, Spirit Tracks, I never even touched that one. I never finished Phantom Hourglass, but I did play it. I've never even touched Minish Cap. I've never touched Oracle of Ages, but I have played and finished Oracle of Seasons. Okay, we'll need to acquire enemy bait before the next one now. Is what this guide says. I did not like... I really did not like what I played of Phantom Hourglass. There's a special shop to get the bait. Let's see. Fastest thing would be to try to teleport to Dungeon 4. Yeah, I've heard really good things about Minish Cap. I'm excited to play that one. Minish Cap is also nice because it is just, you know, a normal Game Boy Zelda game. I'm kind of dreading whenever I go to play some of these other ones. Wait, where am I at? Like, all the DS ones are going to be really annoying to play. When I play Ocarina of Time, I'm a little undecided. Like, playing the Switch version is probably the easiest way to go about it. But I'm also wondering if there are emulators that take the textures from the 3DS version and put it onto like an emulator of some kind where you can play it without all the second screen garbage. That would be pretty cool. I'll probably play the OG versions because those are the ones I have actual physical copies of. I never even bought a Wii U. Let's see. I think if I go up here. Okay, this is an actual fairy. I think the empty one is over here. Yeah, I'm hoping maybe if I take my time with this playthrough series, they'll finally port it over. Hey, look at there. There we go. What is this? This is Dungeon 7? I had no idea. That's how you... Oh. Wow. Okay. Okay, well now I know where that's at. Okay, let's see. Where do I get the bait? I need 60 rupees to buy the bait. So, hopefully I can... I'm just gonna have to kill every enemy I see. Yeah, but see, I don't know if I'll actually get through all of these on stream before Tears of the Kingdom comes out. Like, obviously that would be the ideal way to do this series. But who knows? Given my stream record and my lack of consistency, we'll just have to wait and see what happens. The fact that Mario got a 3-game anniversary edition and Zelda got a Game & Watch clock. I know, dude. Not only that, like, Skyward Sword HD? Why? Who at Nintendo thought that was the celebration fans wanted? Okay, well, this is useless. I still need 11 more rupees. And the shop to buy the bait is here. So that's great. Ooh, 7 more. Okay. Yeah, I mean, I agree with you for sure. Like, if you're not gonna port the HD versions of Twilight Princess and Wind Waker over to Switch, which first of all you totally should, but if you're not going to, can we get like a GameCube on Switch Online? I'll pay extra for that. I think people would probably prefer we get Game Boy first, but like, just give me some way to play those games without having to go buy or dig out a Wii or a GameCube, you know? Like, it's currently I do not have a Wii or a GameCube. I still have my physical copies of Wind Waker and Twilight Princess, but I don't have a way to play them. So I'm gonna have to decide, do I want to go buy a GameCube because I already have those games, or go buy a Wii? Or do I just get a Wii U and get the HD versions of those games on there and play those? So I'm undecided. I'll probably get a GameCube or a Wii and play the copies I already have. That's what I'm thinking is what I'll probably do. And I think these first two games are the only ones I'm really going to use, like, the emulator tricks on as much. Even for Link to the Past, I don't think I'm going to, because I actually have... I paid a pixel artist to replace all of the sprites in Link to the Past with versions of myself. So I can play that game as myself. So that's what I'm planning on doing. That's for Link to the Past. And for Link's Awakening, I think I'm probably going to play the Game Boy Color DX version, because I really don't like the way the remake looks in terms of the graphics. I don't like that art style. So the Switch remake, it just isn't really appealing to me. Okay. Come on, dude. I need 2 more rupees. Help me out. There we go. There's a blue one. Finally. Okay. Alright, so I need to go all the way. What are the main changes that they make in the Twilight Princess HD and Wind Waker HD? I don't even really know what the significant changes are. Other than the visuals, of course. The sailing around looking for tribe. Oh, that's a good upgrade. But with the guide, would it really be that annoying in the original? I don't remember. That's another one of those games I only played one time when it first came out. What? Oh, I'm dumb. It's the next screen. Which shop is this in? Right here. All right. Okay. Now we can go back to... I need to go down... Down, left, 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 up. Oh, that's pretty cool then. But what about Twilight Princess? What's different in that one? All right. Time for dungeon number 7. Okay, we're going to be doing the same thing again. I'm going to go in blind and see how it goes, and then I'll use a guide when I eventually inevitably get stuck. Okay, whoa, boys, hold up. Okay, so not a whole lot of changes for Twilight Princess. That makes sense. And these... Really? I went through all that for some bombs? I was already full on bombs. I think I have the Wolf Link amiibo already. What does it do? I mean, I could be wrong. Hang on. Now I gotta go check. Yeah, I've already got it. What does that do? A challenge cave? Oh, that sounds cool. Alright. Alright, Hunter. You might have convinced me to get a Wii U finally. Okay, what can I do here? Should I try to push every single block on the screen and see what happens? Am I gonna go like full 1986 gamer? I've heard Nintendo Land's cool. I bet, you know what? I bet Preston would love that game. And I bet he would love having a Wii U. Because it's like having a tablet and a console at the same time. So I think maybe that's reason enough right there, right? In Nintendo Land, that's probably a game that'll never get ported. There's not really any way for them to port that. It might get a sequel one day, but I don't think it'll ever get ported. Isn't this the start? Yeah, I think this is the start. I don't know. Let's try bombing some walls because I feel like I've been given a lot of bombs. So, okay, well, I just wasted 2 bombs. Let's go ahead and rewind. I was given a... Oh no, this was the empty room. Hang on. Ha ha ha! I'm gonna be honest, I'm terrified of having to play Adventure of Link. Even with the rewind feature, I feel like that game is gonna be such a pain to play. Maybe I should look up if they have any ROM hacks that make the game a little more forgiving or something, you know? Or should I just suck it up and do it? I know there's some ROM hacks for, like, fan sequels that I've heard are good. Maybe if this series goes well of me playing all the Zelda games, I'll do another series where I play through, like, ROM hacks and stuff. That'd be really fun. Yeah, you're probably right. even with just a guide, that would make it a lot more manageable. But yeah, the rewind feature is going to be pretty clutch. Okay, so this is why it was giving me so many bombs. Don't you need, like, three... You need two each, don't you? Nope. Rewind. Oh boy, 5 rupees for all that. Okay, I'm gonna save my bombs. Talk about a freaking waste. Like, 5 rupees for just wasting 6 bombs like that? What a ripoff. What? What did that do? Oh no. Okay. I already did this room. That's a waste. Okay, let's go this way. Ooh, key. Okay, let's make the rounds here. We're gonna not waste any bombs. I'm gonna cheat so that all bombs are preserved. Okay. There was just a key in that room. I bet you'd like to have more bombs. I would, but I don't have that much money. I'm sorry. Alright. You know what? I don't even know if I tried to go to the left there. That's fine. This is going towards the enemy. I can see the blinking. Did I try the other directions here? I feel like I did. Hey, what's up, Aaron? I beat dungeon 6 a little bit earlier. I'm on dungeon 7 now. Which means I have one more dungeon after this and then the final boss dungeon to defeat Ganon. I have this magic wand now, which is great. It means I have a ranged attack at all times that does real damage instead of just stunning them like the boomerang, you know? Oh yeah, this is that guy that shrinks, right? With the bomb? Or it shrinks when you play the whistle. Me with more bombs. That's kind of cool, I guess. Whoops, wrong button. How was work tonight, Aaron? Okay. Nothing there. Okay. Nothing there. Okay. Nice. Always good to have keys. Can never have too many keys. As you can see, if you're new here, I use the rewind feature very liberally. I'm not wasting any bombs, but I want to check all the rooms. Oh, you pinched a nerve in your neck? That sucks. That does not sound good. There's a secret in the tip of the nose. Oh, okay, alright, alright. I'm not sure what that means, but it's probably important, right? Alright, time to consult the guide and see where the hell I need to go to get to the boss, right? Down, left, left, up, 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 left. You have to turn your whole upper body to look around. Oh my god. That sucks. Okay, yeah, there's a ladder. There's another secret ladder in the top right corner of the map. Oh, there's a red candle that I have to get. Okay. I think I generally see the path I need to take. Let's see if I can figure things out here. I still don't have the map yet. But I've got the compass. Okay, I think this is correct. Already determined it's not worth it to kill those. Really? Okay, so I see where I'm at now. I need to go right, then down. I don't remember if I've been in this room yet. It says defeat all of them, go up, and then go to the left. I've already beat this guy. Oh. This is why you need the bait. Here we go. Thank you. And here's the map, finally. Time to stop messing around. Let's get the wand out. What's everyone's most anticipated games for the rest of the year? Or for the entire year, I guess, technically. For me, Tears of the Kingdom, Zelda, it's gotta be number one. Diablo 4 is way up there. Hogwarts Legacy is way up there. Starfield, Final Fantasy 16. There's just a lot of good games coming out this year that I'm super excited for. People suck at making games? Man, maybe... I'm just going to throw this out there. Maybe you should expand the types of games that you play. That would be my suggestion. Yeah, Hogwarts Legacy is very high on my list for sure. Man, what the hell is the point of this room? Hold on. Oh, I see. I stopped checking for hidden rooms, of course. Naturally. That's when I discover one. Yeah, baby. So what is different about the red candle? Oh, you can use it more often now. Oh, okay, gotcha. Oh yeah, I forgot about Jedi Survivor. Baldur's Gate 3, yes! I played it a little bit in early access because that was back when I was still a journalist, so I was writing some guides. But I have avoided it pretty much entirely because I'm excited to play the final release. Okay. So it looks like... I did play Divinity Original Sin 2. That game's incredible. Loved it. What? Yeah, it's the sequel, Aaron. So, Jedi... Star Wars Jedi... What do they call it? Jedi Fallen Order was the first one, and now the sequel will be Jedi Survivor. Oh my god. Oh my god. This is ridiculous. Okay. Another one of those spinny guys, right? I never finished Fallen Order, to be honest. Ah, god. It's on PlayStation Plus this month, though, for free. Oh, okay, I just need to go right a screen. Metal block that's on the right side of the room. Oh, here we go. Yeah, I really hated Cal. I thought he was a terrible, terrible, terrible protagonist. Dang it, run button. He was so boring. I did... You should be proud of me, Hunter. I played and beat Elden Ring. I don't know if you're aware of that. Man, what is going on? I thought that was the block. It says... the secret, you can push the metal block that is on the right side of the room. Push it and it will cause a secret staircase to appear. Do I have to defeat the... these guys first? The wall masters or whatever? Because it definitely wasn't allowing me to... Oh, yep. You had to beat him first. My main issue with Fallen Order was all the backtracking. I hated that after you, like, completed a planet, you had to basically redo the whole thing in reverse to get off the planet. But I should probably just go ahead and go back to finish it. I think I'd gone to Kashyyyk twice... I want to say? I think? So I was decently far. Oh, that's where I just came from. So now where do I go? Oh, it's just, okay, it's just one screen over. Is this it? What? Why are the bosses so easy in this game? I don't understand. Alright. Alright. This is the final... the final pre-Ganon dungeon. Let's see here. It's at the east end of the map. Okay, the guide recommends getting both bomb upgrades before doing this dungeon. I really don't want to grind for all the money to do that. But, you know what? I could come back here and get this bomb upgrade. It would be kind of easy. And that would at least get me to 12 bombs. So maybe I should get one bomb upgrade first. I just need to go do the gambling game. And then come back here. So maybe if I use the whistle, it can teleport me to get closer to it. I think the bomb upgrade was 100. Whoops. Oh, I know, right? Microtransactions would make this way easier. Yeah, so this did get me closer. Okay. That was actually very convenient this time. That's like in Assassin's Creed Odyssey, where you can spend money to basically double your XP so that you level up faster and the game's less of a grind. I really like that game. Like, I'm being 100% honest, I really love Assassin's Creed Odyssey. But that is just one of the grossest things ever. It's like, hey, we recognize that our game is too grindy, but instead of just balancing it better, we're gonna charge you to increase your XP gain. Alright, here we go. Oh. Whoops. Oh, crap. There we go. Let's try this again. If you're in the chat right now, what is your absolute favorite Zelda game? For me, that answer is Ocarina of Time. And it's probably never going to change. Just because nostalgia is a powerful, powerful drug. There we go. Link to the Past, that's a good choice. It's hard to argue. I mean, Ocarina of Time is basically just a 3D version of Link to the Past, right? All the way down to collect 3 items, get the Master Sword, go to an alternate version of Hyrule. It's like the same game. Alright, I'm over 200 now. That's pretty solid. Okay. Now the question is, will the whistle take me to the Dungeon 7 entrance? It is hidden, so I don't know if it counts. This is the first one, isn't it? Yeah, whatever. So I think the fastest way is for me to go around here. Yeah, I agree with you there, Hunter. Wind Waker definitely has the best soundtrack. Did you ever get a chance to go to the Symphony of the Goddess concert? I can't remember if I talked to you about that or not. That concert was amazing. I fully cried real tears when it got to the Wind Waker section. Okay, where is the bomb salesman. Up, left, up, up. Okay. Yeah, I wonder why I couldn't go. I don't remember. I ended up going after I moved out here. I don't remember. Maybe I had to work or something? There we go. 12 bombs. So now how do I get to dungeon 8? I need to go all the way. It's on the right side. Okay. Dang it. Oh, I was doing that by accident here. Let me go down the screen first. Okay. Did it really just take me? Man, that's so dumb. Okay. Well, this is not helpful. I'm still very far away. This is not helpful. The whistle is really screwing me over right now. Can I not teleport from the screen? Nope. Okay. Come on. Come on. Can I reset? How do you even reset? You lose your health if you die. But I guess I could just go run by the ferry on my way. I mean, at this point, I could have already been there. Let's try the whistle one more time. Let's see where it takes me. Okay. It's just messing with me now. Let's just run. Whatever. Like, would it have been that much more difficult to just add in, like, a prompt of some kind? So you could choose, like, which entrance to teleport to. I know nothing about NES game development, so maybe it really was, it would have been that much more difficult. Who knows? Okay, let's see. Where am I at right now? Ah, dang it. think it's up. Yeah, then up. Then right. Down, right, right, and then you burn. Wait, hang on, I'm confused now. Left and down, okay, I was close. There we go. Here we go. Final dungeon before Ganon. Okay, the guide on ZeldaDungeon.net, shout out to Zelda Dungeon, says that this is a very difficult one. Recommend picking up a potion and getting the bomb upgrades. I got one upgrade, so I'm gonna hope that's enough. Since I can reset, theoretically, it should be. Let's see. Meh. Okay, that does not hurt, apparently. All that for 5 rupees and opening a door. No, I thought I was done with Dark Nuts. Dang it. Of course they deflect magic wands. At least those things don't hurt you. They just make you unable to use your sword for a short time. Haha! This is a book of some kind. Don't actually know what it does. Oh wait, does this just make my wand light stuff on fire? Oh, that's cool. Okay, cool. I can probably use that to light up a room too. So I don't have to keep switching back to the candle. I'm playing a bullet hell shooter now. This isn't even a Zelda game at this point. Really? Was this room completely optional? Oh yeah, baby. Oh my god. I think this is the room that I remembered us being stuck in for a while, Hunter. Because I feel like we either didn't have the ring, or we didn't have the tunic, or at least whenever I was playing it with you. But I could be wrong. These guys. Oh my god. That's so much easier. Yeah, well, I haven't had arrows all game, so I didn't even think about it. I didn't realize you had to buy them before they were available to even use. Oh, okay. What? Oh, it's not open. Okay. I don't like this. Why is this harder than the actual boss? What's going on here? Why is this so much harder than the real boss? There we go. Spectacle Rock is an entrance to death. Okay, so that's gotta be a tip. That's gotta be a tip for how to get to Death Mountain. But I'm following a guide anyway. Okay. Yeah, baby. Okay, I guess we'll go left first. Okay, arrows do not work on these guys. That's unfortunate. Oh my god. God. Oh, sweet baby Jesus. Thank you. Don't feel like getting the wand out. Oh god, these are blue ones. Oh, Jesus. Wait, didn't I already fight these? I think I already did that room. Yeah. Okay, let's see here. Where am I currently? You're supposed to fight those guys. Go there. Okay, the compass room I already got. So I need to go... Oh, jeez. This is the start. Hang on. I don't really need this key, but it'll probably be helpful just to have extras, right? The room to have the compass was... that way, right? I think this is the room to have the compass. Yes. Why don't they stay defeated? I'm so confused. I thought that was how this game worked. Let's use one of the potions now. At the top of the room. Okay, so let's see. I need to go defeat those dark nuts and then go up and then use a bomb to go up again. I don't think this even does anything against them. Bombs work. They just don't do very much damage. See, I could have sworn I beat these guys already. Maybe there was just another room with a bunch of blue dark nuts. I'm getting it confused, I guess. Jeez. God, I hate those things. Okay, I'm confused again. Okay, head up and then use a bomb again to go up again. Okay. Oh, this is disgusting. Okay, now what? Head up. And then right. Oh, jeez, man. Come on. Why? No! Oh, god. Like a fancy boss key or something. That's cool. Oh, is that like infinite keys? Oh. It is infinite keys. Head left the screen, go back down to... Left, down to, then defeat all those dark nuts. Okay, great. What's up here? Okay. God, I just keep getting stuck. All right, I think I'm gonna have to heal again. Potions are clutch, man. Okay, well, that's annoying. Really? Yes! God, I hate you. I hate you so much. I hate you. Hang on. There's got to be a more efficient way of me doing this. I lost so many hearts. This is so frustrating. Oh my god. Oh, Jesus. Okay, do I have to fight these guys or can I just run past them? I can just run past them. Okay. Northern Wall, all right. I don't need that key, obviously. Is this the boss? Tenth enemy has the bomb. Hang on, wait a second. I don't think it... Okay, according to the map, this should be the entrance. Okay. That's crazy. I could have completely missed the boss fight. Okay, arrows don't do anything. I don't think that does anything either. No. It's only weak to the sword. Two down. Three down. There we go. There we go. I've got every heart in the game now. Triforce completed. Now it's time to take on Ganon. I gotta figure out where to go. G to the G, that's right, thank you very much. Let's get a Preston GG in here, thank you, thank you. Alright, let's see. From the start screen, it says go right and then up 5. So I'm near-ish to the start. Let's head back there. Really? Okay. Let's erase that. Okay. We're almost done. This is the home stretch now. No hearts, okay. Man, these guys are dropping money like crazy over here. Okay, so this is right one. Now I need to go up 1, 2, 3. Okay. 4, 5. Then let's loop around. Okay. All right. Go to the left. We're gonna go up. Then, do we go up the stairs? I think we go up the stairs. Go left here. Okay, it looks like according to this guide, there should be... Oh my god. A potion shop. Aw, oh, parrots, I'm sorry, I don't have my sound alert set up. I apologize. Okay, I'll do the scream. I'm not gonna actually scream because I have two sleeping children and a wife and it's almost midnight. I'm sorry for scaring you. It's a new song. That's a spooky song right there. That's some Ganon music. All right, man, look at that. I've got the full Triforce. You can't see it right now. Hold on. I want to appreciate having the full Triforce of Wisdom in my grasp here. Behold. All right, let's do this. Okay, I think because I have the Triforce, I'm able to pass here. I'm just following the guide at this point. I feel like this dungeon would be super annoying if I was not following the guide. As you can already tell, oh my god, this is completely ridiculous. I'm basically almost dead in the first room. Okay, this feels like a job for a bow and arrow. Oh yeah! Snipes! Look at those sniper shots. Okay. Did I just lose my magical shield? Is that the tiny shield again? I can't tell. I'm not sure. I really hope not. Let's go back. Let's just rewind it. Have I lost my magical shield already? I think I did. I don't have the magic shield anymore. Do I need it? Now I'm freaking out. don't think I can block any of Ganon's fireballs with the magic shield. Yeah, so I don't think I really even need it. I don't think it serves much of a purpose. Okay, I think I'm good. Let's just continue forth. Bomb the wall at the bottom for the compass. Otherwise, just go to the right. Hang on, I'm confused. Okay, they'll rotate around the larger eye. Oh, I just need to go down a screen. Okay, I don't need to defeat this one, is what it says. Okay. And bomb the wall to the right. I'm just gonna follow the guide exactly. It makes it much more efficient for the final dungeon here. I just need to blow open the wall at the top of the screen to get through here. Oh my god, that thing did serious damage. I need to heal now. Immediately lost two hearts. Jesus. That's not what I meant to do. Okay, let's redo this little section here though. Hang on. Whatever. I lost four hearts. Red ring! So that gives me the red tunic. Okay, sweet. That's now the final tunic, right? So it takes even less damage. 1/4 of the original damage. Okay. Sweet. Can you guys leave me alone, please? Okay. Head down. Hang on. Here we go. go to the next room. All right, thanks. Super helpful. Some delicious rupees. Hang on. Left, left. Can I light this room up, or is this just... it's just a black room? Okay. They just forgot to place the tiles in that one or something? Okay, I need to, so I have to actually defeat this one. Which is not good. God. Did I really just do that? Wow. That felt like pure luck, but I'll take it. It's fine by me. Potions, so hopefully... oh god. Oh man. I have to defeat these guys. Do arrows hurt them? Nope. Sword only, huh? And of course I don't have my magic shield anymore. Jesus. This is terrible. Every time I tried the wand, it wouldn't work on those guys. But maybe I was wrong. Maybe it didn't work previously, but now that it's upgraded, it does. I don't know. So what did that do? Oh, it's a silver arrow. That's like the light arrows you get in the later games. That's for damaging Ganon, okay. head down a screen, defeat to reach the staircase, go back through the underground tunnel to get back to the room, okay, and then head up a screen. Nope. I refuse. Okay. Head up and then go up again. Oh my god. I can see why the magic shield is so useful in here, because of the whiz robes. Go up a screen, and then bomb the left wall. Let's try this again. Defeat the wizards and push the block on the left. Oh god, hang on. Okay. I've only got two bombs left. Please tell me I can skip these guys. Yeah, bomb the left wall. Oh my god, this is crazy. I think I'm done with the bombs, though. Ow! Crap. Oh my god. How am I gonna get out of this? I feel like there's gotta be a way for me to maneuver this. Okay, I've got half my hearts. This isn't too terrible. Maybe some of these guys will drop some hearts or something. That'd be really nice. This is... Oh, crap. Do I have to fight this guy, too? This is the final boss here. Through this door. Okay, let me read some tips on fighting Ganon real quick. It says, he'll shoot fireballs, which are unblockable. He moves around in a pattern, so hit at one of the locations he shoots from, and you'll find him. Each time you strike him, he will change his pattern. This phase is quite random and could be annoying. I find it best to stay at one corner or part of the room and just keep slashing away until you hit him. After striking him four times, he'll become brown. This is your sign that he is nearly defeated. Whip out that bow and sling the silver arrow at him. Alright, cool. We're almost there then. This is almost done. Let's see. Can I use the bomb on this thing? Or this is the one that has to be... Alright. I'm gonna do a save point and see if this is enough hearts to get through this fight. If it's not, I'll have to come back and try something else. I'm out of bombs. I don't think I need them for this fight anyway, though. Oh! What's the point of the platforms? Got them once, right? Got him twice. Got him three times. Got him. Oh! That was fast. I think that's just because of all the upgraded gear and stuff that I spent the time getting. Wow. That went a little more quickly than I was expecting. I have both pieces of the Triforce now, right? There she is! I've rescued you. Thanks, Link. You're the hero of Hyrule. Back when the Triforce was only two pieces. Peace returns to Hyrule. The end. We did it! Yamauchi. Another quest. Yeah, I'm not doing the second quest. That's a great song. We won! Victory! This is a great song. Hold up. Is it just restarting? Oh, you basically lose all your progress. I wasn't expecting that. Alright, so let's save over this. And I'll have my fully loaded file here right before the boss fight. What was I supposed to do? There we go. All right, so this is starting over. Which is, what is this one then? This is the second quest, but what does that mean? I don't even remember what the second quest was, or maybe I just don't know what that is. Huh, okay. Oh, the dungeons are in a different order, okay. Alright, well, there we go. There we go, boys and girls. We have completed the original Legend of Zelda on NES, which means our next adventure is going to be Zelda II, The Adventure of Link. Will be our next one. Here it is, right here. I'm gonna kick this one off on Sunday, I think. We'll see how it goes. It's got a great opening and great theme song. Really good stuff. Great music. I think the farthest I ever got in this one was like the third temple. So yeah, I have not completed this or even gotten close. This will be a tough one. Alright, well, thank you everybody for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed watching me play The Legend of Zelda over these last two streams. I will probably be back on Sunday is what I'm thinking to kick things off with Zelda 2. So yeah, good times. Thank you everybody. I will be uploading the VODs of my playthroughs over on my YouTube channel if that is something that you want to check out. I have some other footage and other VODs and stuff over there already, just from previous playthroughs and games and other types of videos. Oh yeah, I should probably raid someone. I don't even know how to do that on Twitch. Let's see if I can figure it out. EDDBOII. Maybe I can just type it in the chat. Does that work? Is there a command for it? There we go. Did that work? All right, go ahead and head on over to that chat. I appreciate it, everybody. Thank you for tuning in.
Ocarina of Time, I love you. If you say Majora's Mask, I love you still. Say Breath of the Wild. He picked you on his own, I swear. Carrots. You're a liar. I love you though. What's up, Jaggernaut? Yeah, dude, my friend Chris got me back on this game.
Look at this. I didn't do anything.
Shut up. How was Zelda, though, dude? That's what I want to talk about. I love Zelda, dude. They call me a Zelda 4. Like, I just love playing it so much. I know a couple of speedrunning tricks on Breath of the Wild. Oh, nice. you playing through all of them this year? So you just finished your original? Nice, nice, nice. I need to play through the original first one. Yeah, I haven't played the first two original ones and the Oracle games.